adversity that can help you in this particular situation after such a difficult game one loss?
It's a new day. For me, I woke up, I'm feeling excited about the opportunity for us to get better today, and excited about the opportunity that presents itself tomorrow and myself. But I can never compare the adversity I went through when I was younger compared to playing basketball. This is just basketball. This is not adversity. Not with the things that I've been through in my life. This is fun.
And secondly, George Hill said yesterday that for him, game one was the toughest loss in his entire career. How can you as a leader help lift a player like that who maybe hasn't been through it before?
We both went through some of the same, emotions. Some of the toughest losses I've had in my career as well. Because everything that kind of went on with the game and the way we played, and obviously we all know what happened in the game. So it was a tough 24 hours, not only for G Hill, but for myself, for our whole ball club, because we put ourselves in a great position to be successful. But like I said, give yourself a day. If you need to take 2 days, okay. But today you should feel excited about the opportunity to be better and be great. Move forward.
Tom, right. Tom Haverster, Bleacher Report. LeBron, I know you've talked a lot about how important sleep is for your recovery and how vital it is for your performance. I remember back in Miami, Dwayne was always team no sleep. But I was curious, when do you believe that sleep was this weapon for you, and how that evolved throughout your career, whether you were prioritizing it when you were a rookie, and when did that really impact you?
I think as you get older, you understand what benefits your body more and more. Depending on what you put in your body as far as food and nutrition, things like that, how many hours a night that you try to get. Now, obviously some nights are different from others, but how much optimal sleep you will want to get to help your body recover. How much working out and things that that you do. I think every individual is different. I found a great balance in what helps me be in the best possible shape I can be on a day-to-day basis, and I just try to follow that.
But early in your career, did you have the same appreciation for it, or did you just learn over time?
No. I was 18 when I came to the league. I didn't I could do whatever I wanted to do. I could stay up throughout the whole night and play 48 minutes the next night and then not ice after the game and go right home. So when I was 18, I didn't even take my rookie year. I'm totally different.
Ken, back right.
Ken Berger, Bleacher Report, here to your right, LeBron. Years ago, there was a concept known as the Jordan Rules, just certain principles the teams believed they had to live by in order to defend him. Given all the approaches that you've seen throughout your career, all the coverages, all the different looks that you get from game to game in a series like this and even within a game, how would you define the LeBron Rules?
I don't think there are LeBron Rules. For me personally, a coaching staff puts together a game plan that best suits his team, best suits the individual. We're going against myself and my teammates, and they try to be successful with that. Obviously, we all heard of the quote-unquote Jordan rules or whatever the case may be, and whoever decided to bring that notion up and a way to stop Jordan. But I think more importantly, this is a team game, and the coaching staff put together game plans that best fits their team. To stop that, either that dynamic player, but also the rest of the guys on the floor as well.
What would you say is the biggest difference in how you're defended now versus when you early in your career when you first came into the league?
There were parts of my game that you could disrespect early in my career. You can't do that now.
Joe in the third row.
Joe Varden, Cleveland.com. LeBron, we can't see it under your hat, so how's your eye today?
It's better. It doesn't look better, but the docs told me it's better, and it's just going through its stages right now, recovering. But it looks worse than it did during the game, but it feels better.
I have a different follow-up after this, but so did you basically score 51 points with one eye that was blurry?
Nah, I had some points before that already.
Can you see now? I mean, is it still blurry?
Well, I'm taking my medication that I've been given by the doctors. My eye drops and my antibiotic to help me with the recovery as fast as possible. But it's an eye. I mean, it's gonna recover as fast as it can on its own. It's nothing that you can do. It's not like I can kind of like ice it or anything like that. Or if I get more sleep or whatever case may be, I just have to naturally, organically let it heal. Like I said, it's been better, but it's better today than it was in game one. Like I said, it doesn't look better, but it feels a lot better.
And then the other question I had was, as game one was starting, Dan Gilbert sent out a number of tweets basically with his thoughts on how this team made it to the finals this year. Were you aware of those tweets, and did you have any reaction to them after the game?
No, not aware. I'm not on social media right now, so I wasn't aware of that. It was his account though, right?
Is this thing on?
Tim in the back right.